Hey guys, in this video, we will talk about multiple level inheritance. So, it is a cup of tea if you guys are aware with the inheritance introduction problem which I discussed in the video. You can click on this eye icon and go there and watch it. This problem will be really easy for you if you are acquainted with that problem or if you are acquainted with inheritance in C++. I have discussed that as well. You can again go to the eye icon and watch that video as well. So, see, now we are going to talk about multiple level inheritance. Like, it means that suppose you have a class. Other classes inheriting it and some other classes inheriting that class as well. So it means there is one class which is the child class, it has one parent class and it has a grandparent class as well. So it means that the class that is the child class that can get access to the attributes and methods or functions of its parent class and also of its grandparents class and can have methods of its own as well. By methods I mean functions. Methods I said because I am acquainted to Java, but fine, functions and attributes, it can basically get its own, the child class can have its own functions and attributes and it can use or get access to the methods from its parent class and the methods from its grandparents class as well. So to do that, I'll explain to you all the code that is there over. I'll just copy that thing and paste it over here. So fine. So this all is easy, include. We don't need these things, but it's fine. They have included it. We have a class called triangle. We have a public method triangle, which will simply print out I am a triangle. Then we have a class called isosceles, which is inheriting variety because it is using a colon and it is saying public triangle. It is saying public, that's why you can get access. If you don't add public, then we can't get access to its public methods, remember. So that's why you have to specifically mention public and then the name of the class that should be the parent class. So for now, isosceles is a child class and triangle is the parent class. So let us do one thing, let us just comment it out and write over here. So for now, what do we know is, we know that our isosceles, so the greatest class is the triangle class. So I'm going to write triangle. It is the greatest class, right? It is the parent of isosceles. So I'm going to say isosceles. So basically isosceles is the child and triangle is the parent. So I think spelling is wrong, but it is fine. So afterwards, what I'm going to do is isosceles. Now it is okay. So okay. Afterwards, we are again having a public method isosceles and it is printing out I'm an isosceles triangle. Now what the thing is, if you see, it is creating an object of type equator. It means that we need to create a class of this type first. So it is saying write your code, so I'll why not write it, right? So I'll create a class called equator, and in this class, so if you guys see, it is saying the object name dot equator. It means that this should be a method. So for that to be a method, I'll simply first of all, it should be a public method, so public, and then I'm going to say a void method called equator. And what does it do? It is going to simply return something. So not return, actually, it is going to print out something, and that something is what I need to just check it from here. Okay, it is just going to print out I am an equilateral triangle. So why not copy that thing and paste it over here. So just paste and don't forget backslash n because it has to go to a new line after each and every line that it prints out. So this all is fine. So if you guys see, we are getting red lines over here. Why? I'll tell you in a while. So we are having object of type equilateral. So we are having an object of this class. It is saying the object name dot equilateral. So it will print out I am an equilateral triangle. So actually we have to do that. That's what we have to do. We have to print out these statements. So it will print out I am an equilateral triangle. So if you guys see, it is saying equilateral dot isosceles. So to get access to this isosceles method, which is there in the isosceles class. So it means that I want to get access of the isosceles class, of the method in the isosceles class, or the function in the isosceles class. So to do that, I have to inherit that class. So to inherit that class, what I'll do, I'll write colon and I'll write isosceles. But as I told you all before, I still have these red lines because as I told you all before, I want to get access to the public method. So for that, we need to write the public keyword. So when I write public, now we have no error. So if I write equilateral.isosceles, now remember, we have to consider this chain as well. So our isosceles triangle isosceles class was the child first and this was the parent. Now the case is that isosceles is the parent and our child is equilateral. So it means that equilateral, okay. So now what's the case? You can say that if you say that equilateral is the child class, isosceles is the parent class, now this becomes grandparent. So it means that this equilateral class can get access to the methods in isosceles class and the methods from child class, sorry, the triangle class, and can have methods of its own as well, which it has actually. So if you guys see, it will print out by using this method, I am an equal triangle. If I click over here, the highlight of isosceles, it is highlighted over here as well. So it will print out I am an isosceles triangle, and if you click over here, it will, this triangle will get highlighted and it will print, I'm a triangle, and that's what we had supposed to do in this problem. So I think that's all about it. If you run this code and see what happens, it will simply print out the required output that we want. So yeah, it is working perfectly fine. So to check if it is actually working or not, just copy this thing. So again, if you guys see over here, it has the symbol over here. It means who is his parent. If you click over here, we get isosceles. If you click over here, we get triangle. So if you guys see, triangle is get, you are having down arrow. It means triangle is as a parent. And over here we have down arrow and up arrow as well. Up arrow means triangle is the parent. Down arrow means equilateral is the child. And for equilateral, up arrow means the isosceles is the parent. So basically, you guys know that isosceles is the middle one. Above it is a triangle. Below it is the equilateral triangle. I explained too much about this thing, I guess. So I just have to paste that class equilator lower and submit this code, because one of the, this thing is working perfectly fine. We don't have to check the sample case, and there's only one test case. So that's all from my side. If you guys have any doubts, oh wow, I got 5th star. So if you guys have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. That's all from my side. You can subscribe to the channel to get updates regarding new videos. That's all. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned and keep learning. Thank you.